Good afternoon, everybody. Initially, I would like to thank the organization of this event, extending my thanks to all, ladies and gentlemen, for the possibility of presenting the perspectives and opportunities of the projects in the mining and energy sectors in Brazil. Projections of GDP growth in Brazil indicate an increase in the need for energy supply. Thus, strategic planning is fundamental for the identification and formulation of the best policies to be implemented and the best options of energy sources. In order to cope with energy consumption and projects in the mining area, it will be required in the coming years investments of approximately, until 2027, $377 billion in oil, gas, and biofuels, and $100 billion in electricity, and until 2022, $20 billion in the mining sector. The Brazilian energy matrix is unique. Brazil has one of the most renewable energy matrices in the world. In 2016, the Brazilian energy matrix was composed of 44% of renewable sources, in contrast to 14% of the world average. In fact, Brazil encouraged the adoption of technological solutions, particularly in the field of renewable energy sources. In fact, Brazil began its energy transition efforts many decades ago, in the 70s from the last century, with large investments in hydroelectric power and biofuels. Thus, in order to create an attractive environment for investments under the guidance of President Bolsonaro, we implement public policies based on the following pillars: improved governance standards, regulatory and legal security, predictability through planned auctions, respect for contracts and assurance of receivables and sustainability of the agenda. If you allow me, I will highlight some of the most important auctions on our agenda for the near future. With regard to the bidding rounds of blocks for the oil and gas sector, this year, in addition to the auction of the surplus volumes of the transfer of rights, which will certainly be the largest ever held, we will have the sixth round of production sharing with areas of high potential and the 16th round of bids for exploratory blocks in the form of concession. In the natural gas sector, the government is working on the design of the new natural gas markets program with a view to forming an open, dynamic, and competitive market. The following results are expected: use of gas from the pre-salt, from the basins of Espírito Santo, Sergipe, Alagoas, and others; investments in infrastructure for the flow, processing, and transportation of natural gas; increase in gas-fired thermoelectric generation with a reduction in the price of energy, Mr. Paulo Guedes; and increase in industrial activity. In the refining, distribution, and resale sector, our goal is to promote a business environment with an emphasis on the entry of new agents and free competition. In this regard, in compliance with the guidelines of the National Energy Policy Council, the largest national oil company, Petrobras, began a divestment program. In order to meet the demands of economic growth, the energy sector will require investments of about $100 billion, as I said before, in new generation plants, due to an estimated 35% growth of the system and in transmission systems with an expected growth of 39% in 10 years. In order to guide future investments in the sector, the 10-year energy plan is updated annually and published in December. With regard to public auctions for the generation and transmission of energy, there is an extensive agenda of events scheduled for 2019, 20, and 21, which will ensure long-term agreements for select projects. The mining sector is of growing importance to the Brazilian economy, with enormous development potential. Brazil has 50 types of mineral commodities with no reserves, in addition to more than 9,400 active mines, being today the third in value of mineral production after Australia and Canada. The sector generates 2.7 million direct and indirect jobs, and Brazilian mineral production represents 4% of GDP. In 2018, the sector's exports totaled almost $50 billion. The sector offers some interesting investment opportunities in areas currently under the national mining rights of the National Mining Agency, the Geological Survey of Brazil, and Petrobras. Therefore, I try to demonstrate some of the numerous investment opportunities in mining and energy sectors in Brazil briefly. We will continue our exercise of permanent and transparent dialogue with all stakeholders, with a view to overcoming obstacles and improving working methods and making Brazil an increasingly attractive country for investors. I invite you all so that together we can open a new chapter of prosperity in Brazilian history. Thank you.